In 1994, a Burmese couple generously donated 14 acres of undeveloped forest land to the Venerable Sayadaw U Pandita in order to establish a new meditation center in Myanmar. Inspired by the prospects of having a major meditation center in this quiet rural setting, others donated even more land, until it reached its present size of over 100 acres. Now known as the Pandita Forest Meditation Center, is located about an hour and 30 minutes drive north of Yangon, formerly called Rangoon, and about 10 miles from a city called Bago. The center is set back almost 2 miles from the main road, thus ensuring the quietude necessary to support intensive meditation practice. It is also not far from the Mahabodhi Forest Monastery, where Sayadaw was ordained at 18 as a full monk. What you're about to see has miraculously appeared in only 5 years' time. Sayadaw emphasized that this new center should maintain high standards of cleanliness and hygiene, so that meditators from all over the world will be encouraged to come and practice Satipatthana Vipassana meditation. This has truly been an international project, as people from all over the world have generously and enthusiastically donated money, skills, and years of hard work to help develop this unique center. Right after entering the main gate is the two-level kitchen and dining hall. The large modern octagon design was selected by Sayadawji, and it could feed over 500 people. This is the bird's eye view of the center from the upper level of the dining hall. Directly ahead is one of the large water reservoirs, and in the distance, you can see the red tiled roof of the meditation hall. Further down the path is the Venerable Sayadawji's own kuti. The path leading from the dining hall past Sayadawji's living quarters goes directly to the meditation hall. Halfway down the path is the Sima building for the ordination of monks. This walk takes one on a bridge which passes over a large forested area designated for preservation. The two-story meditation hall has room for 6 to 7 women on the ground level and the same amount for men on the upper level. A new separate men's meditation hall is being built close by, and once it's completed, the women will occupy both floors of the current building. Directly across from the meditation hall is a separate building for teacher-student interviews. A short walk from the meditation hall is the Gandakuti, a very special pagoda housing a shrine and image of the Buddha. It can also be used for meditation or Dhamma discussions. Most of the meditation huts, called kutis, are constructed from ironwood, a wood well known in Burma for its hardness and durability. The kutis are spacious, sturdy, and quite conducive to a meditative lifestyle. This area is designated for monks and male yogis. A long covered bridge provides a direct path from the meditation hall to the women's compound. Over 2 acres of expertly farmed land provides the center with much of its fruits and vegetables. Today we will spend the entire day with the yogis who are participating in the annual two-month retreat. The day typically begins at 3 a.m., with breakfast at 5:30 a.m. and lunch at 10:30 a.m. There's no eating after 12 noon. There are interviews with one of the teachers in the morning and a Dhamma talk in the afternoon. The last sitting ends at 10 p.m. Yogis are expected to stay continuous with their practice throughout the entire day.
Did you think when Buddha talked about this, did you think it is in the equilibrium, in your balance? Where this vibration, in your abdomen or any other parts of your body?
Usually in the head or in my parts of the body.
With a lot of force, probably on the eye level, and mental images, not only the image. And again, return to the breath, and then breathing with slowed all my movements way down. It was much easier to keep the continuity. Watched it change about a half hour.
The object would freeze.
Intention to observe knowing more closely.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The yogis who come for meditation are completely supported by generous donations. There are no fees charged for housing, meals, or teaching. At this center, some of the best meditation teachers in the world are available to all who come to earnestly practice what the Buddha taught. This center is an oasis of sanity in an insane world, and we should all generously support such a noble project. Please contact Sadama Foundation to offer your tax-free donation.
May they be free from enmity and danger. May they be free from mental suffering. May they be free from physical suffering. May they take care of themselves.